This is Brad Wild, and this is a very quick, well not quick, but a video that is basically just getting in this airplane and flying it from Los Angeles to San Francisco. Now I'm flying the This is the SRG 170. This is version 1.06, the most recent one. And I'm still trying to master everything from cruise to descent. I have the programming of the FMS through the MCDU figured out. I have takeoff and managed climb, but it's the descent that is troubling. I have been able to make a successful ILS approach, so let's see if we can't work a little bit on that descent. So inside the cockpit, I'm not completely wild about this cockpit. Some things look a little skewed and stretched. And the reason I notice this so quickly is if you fly the Embraer 175 from X-Crafts, you'll notice a significant difference. The X-Crafts version is a lot more realistic or natural feeling. Anyway, not much of a checklist is needed for this aircraft because so little of it is actually simulated. But starting at the top and working down, the GPU is available, so I'll go ahead and click that on. These are all on auto. In normal flight, all of these switches should be in the 12 o'clock position. So I'll just keep turning things on here. Let's see, I've got seat belts. I don't know why those are on. Turn on the beacons and the nav, electrical pump, and we can go ahead and start the APU, and you'll see that appear down here. So I'll go ahead and click that. It's a momentary switch, flips back to on, and you're not going to hear much difference in any of the sounds, which is very disappointing, especially after you have used something like the Blue Sky simulations. Those sounds are quite realistic and amazing to hear people in the background talking and so on. Anyway, you can see our APU is coming up. And once it is, there's no aligning that you have to do. It's the IRS is all done for you. And I've never really seen it get to 100%. Maybe I just haven't noticed. So we can go ahead and turn off the GPU and disconnect it here. I don't want to see the yoke. I don't need rain. The rain is not really exciting in this aircraft, not very realistic at all. And just make sure everything is copacetic here. Yep. And that little beep is our PFD showing up. So now it's time to program our MCDU, or I'm sorry, use the MCDU to program our FMS. So let me pull up a map here. So let me pull up a map here. We'll use sky vectors. As a reference, but let's go over to FlightAware and see what we have between LA and San Francisco. I'm sure there's a lot. I'm sure that's a very busy route. So let's find something that's close to our takeoff time. All right, we have one here, Compass Airlines, here's United. Let's go with United. And here's our route here in its abbreviated form, or its uncoded, decoded form, encoded, I guess. And here is our actual waypoint by waypoint flight plan. So I'm going to go ahead and make a screenshot of that, and I'll have it on my second monitor just so that I can reference it. But the thing I'm interested in here is the SID VTU-7, and then we've got SERFR-2 for our approach. I'm actually not familiar with that one, so that'll be kind of interesting. So back to Sky Vector, and got a flight in from the other day. Let me go ahead and put this in. And I'll see if there's anything suggested here, and there really isn't. So, we'll forget that and just use our own route, which is going to be VTU-7. And it's showing here the San Marcos VOR, which is lines up with our approach, I mean our departure that we got from FlightAware. And then we go to Surfer, I guess would be the way you would say that. And finally we'll put in our star, Surfer 2. Well, didn't like that either. Try it here. Can't seem to get that to work. There we go. So you can see our route has been plugged in here. So we get a sense of, general sense of, how it's going to look from the air. So let's head on over to our airplane here. So we'll start with our dent. We've got close to the latest RRAC pause and dent. I'll go ahead and put this in. I haven't been able to figure out the keyboard. So I supposedly this little button here, I click it and nothing happens. I don't have a lot of entry, so not a huge deal. So LAX. And over to route. And got stuff in from last night. So what I should do is go back to the menu and clear this whole thing. So initialize, activate, and let's start over again. That clears out your previous flight. So KSFO. forget. Don't need a flight number. And this is our performance screen. I'm not going to go there just yet. Do departure first, and we'll take off to the west. Let's see which runways here I'm closest to. Go to the map and zoom in. So I'm probably going to be taking off on one of these two runways, only because it's the closest. So how do we tell which runway that is? We'll go over to our map, airport diagram. So we are parked here, and so that's going to be 24 left. And let's see if we can find that. Yep, good. And our San Marcos VOR is our transition. Go ahead and activate that. Then you click on nav and go over to arrival. And we're going to be landing on ILS 28 right. And the star is Surfer. Transition Surfer. And we can choose here where we are going to intercept the ILS, and I'm going to go with Menlo. Dumbo and the other one, Menlo is, I forget what the other one was, but they are a little bit further east. So all that's activated. So if you go over to your flight plan, you can see those. Let's just check for discontinuities. We have one here, and I'm not sure. Yeah, there's, and looking at our flight plan, there's nothing missing from what we're seeing here on the MCDU in terms of the waypoints. So I'm going to go ahead and click, put this in the scratch pad, click here, and activate it. And just check back through, it looks good. All right, so the only thing that we are missing, by the way, you'll see some altitudes here. Those are come from the default altitude that you're given for a flight. So let's go ahead and give it our own. So we'll start over here with performance, go to takeoff, laps of two. I'll put these in, but it's going to bark at me on the next screen when I put in a flux temp. So we go back, oops, performance, takeoff. See, these have disappeared. And I'm just going to leave these values as they are. So then over to our menu. Let's see, what's next? I'm going to set our altitudes here. Okay, where do we do that? Flight plan? No. Route data? Nope. Alright, this is a little embarrassing. I'm looking for it. Here it is. Alright, so here's our transition of 10,000 feet. But our cruise altitude right now is at flight level 370. We don't want that. It's a short enough flight. So let's just go with Flight level 280. I think you have to put in the zeros, yes. Now, I thought when you put this in, you're asked to confirm this, but I'm not seeing that. Just check our flight plan, make sure everything is copacetic there. Looks like everything has been figured. So I will consider our FMS to be programmed. Nothing else we need to do here. Now you're supposed to be able to pop this out. F8. Aha. That's nice. Maybe you have to have this popped out in order to use the keyboard. Yep, here's the keyboard. Very good. Now that we're already programmed here, not quite sure how to get it back. Let's see if, yep, F8 works fine. So I guess we can go ahead and do our pushback. We can just go through our screens here, making sure. Oh, this is our, you can see our, I'm using my joystick to go through those. Hydraulics, we don't have the engine started, so all of these are not going to be lit up. Same thing here, our fuel. Electrical, still drawing from the APU. Not sure what that does, but not much. Don't have to worry about ice today. Here's our map. So we're facing east, and we'll see it a little clearer when we take off. And we want to identify our waypoints by name. And I've not used the push in this aircraft. This is fuel. I'm not going to touch that for right now. So I'm going to click in to engage tow, release park brake. Okay. I don't know why it says stop. Tow engaged, stop. Let's see what that looks like. All right, there's our tow. Let's see how we're going to steer this guy. Yeah. Just using my joystick. Kind of a crude representation there of pushing. Make the one that comes with the X-Crafts 175 is a little more realistic. And I'll hop back in. Yeah, it'd be nice to have this pop out so I could see it when I was outside. So we'll disengage. And he's just disappeared. Okay, not a very good parking job. So let's start our engines. Don't think we need to do anything in the overhead. Let's just drop down and open these up. There you go. And no appreciable sound difference. All of a sudden you just kind of hear this loud vacuuming sound. Not loud, but no spool up or anything, just sound. All right, coming up here, let's go ahead and start engine number one. And the X-crafts, you have to turn these on. And it's coming up. Waiting to see this change. There we go. This continues to climb. Not sure how high it gets. So these little guards have replaced themselves. It looks like it stabilizes about 27. So we can go ahead and turn off our APU. And how about a taxi light? I'll turn on the logo light, keep the branding guys happy. And looks like our parking brake is still off, which is kind of funny that we're not rolling. I probably should have turned that on. And let's set our flaps to 2. You don't really arm your speed brake. Go ahead and set my auto brake to rejected takeoff. And we can taxi over to the runway. Spooling up. And we just have a short jaunt here. By the way, if you turn too quickly in this airplane, it will just stop rolling. All right, back in a minute. So we are holding here at 24 left. Let's just take care of a couple things. Let's get the lights on. Don't need strobes at this point. Don't need taxi lights at this point. Now, I need to make sure that this is set to the FMS. Right now, speed is manual. I can set it to, let's see, there we go. Now it's set to the FMS, so it's 200, flight level 10,000. So after I take off, I'm going to click autopilot, nav, autothrust, VNAV, or in some order. But those are the ones that are operable. Let me turn on my flight director. I can turn on. By the way, you don't get any lights up here, and apparently, from what I've seen, there are no lights in the actual aircraft. So we are at a disadvantage here in a simulator because we're not can't actually see whether or not it's pressed in or not. So I do like what the 175 does. It gives you some lights. and it's a little bit more reassuring. All right, let's roll. Start my clock. Release the brake. I do like the flight characteristics. We're just hand flying. Taxiing is a little taxiing. Taxiing. If you turn it too sharply, it will just stop. So you have to make nice and gentle moves. Hopefully we won't be too far down the runway. Now they call for a rolling takeoff in some of the docks I've seen. So we'll just go ahead and we should see takeoff appear in the, or TO, no takeoff trim. Well, it's too late now. Okay, that was
80 knots.
An oversight on my part. Now, I don't want to be in the red.
V1, VR, V2.
I never saw the TO in there. Guess I'm not looking at it in the right place. You're up. And I'll maintain about 15 degrees here. Go ahead and turn on my... Whoops. Didn't mean to roll yet. So, all right, so I've got everything flashing here. LNAV, flight level change, kind of sloppy. Put a flap up. But it looks like we're on target here. This is kind of awkward. So you can see by our profile that we're climbing up to the path. So everything is auto. I'm just letting the plane fly itself. I'm not doing anything. And it's because I set the FMA, it's now, the speed is now 250, which is fine up to 10,000 feet. By the way, this is still X-plane 10.5, whatever they're up to, 1. And you can see the little arch here that shows where we will hit our 10,000 mark. Get a little more range here. This is Ventura, our VOR. Now, I did not hear a little beep. Oh, there you go, 500 feet. And things come back. By the way, this little red line is because I have my shadows on, and it's something to do with my graphics card. If I turn off the shadows, then it goes away. So we are at altitude. So it's telling me I need to put in my cruise altitude, which is kind of weird. It seems like it should just go to that, but I know in the default FMS, and like in the 175, this just automatically changes. Same thing in something more sophisticated like the JAR A320. So I'll go ahead and put it in there. All right, so I will click B now. And we spool up. We begin our climb. I think we're just picking up speed here. 280. So this is Ventura, Oxnard. Top of descent here. Reset this view. This key is here in the FMA, keeping an eye on that. So you can see our top of climb here, and our little arch is set perfectly. So that's good. And now that we're above 10,000, we can turn off the lights. Actually, the nose light should come off as soon as you get the gear folded up. Red line, we can look over the nose. So this is Santa Barbara coming up from this area. So we head over to Ventura. Here's the San Diego Airport.
single island, basically uninhabited, by seals.
And we're going to miss our top of climb by a little bit here. Again, because it's in magenta, it means it's vanished. So I'm just wondering about this. Alright, I've had problems with this leveling off and staying at the cruise altitude, so we'll see how this does. So, join me in a few minutes. Alright, you can see we're coming up on our top of climb. Flight level 280. It's been 14 minutes after takeoff. Didn't hear a beep. Santa Barbara below us. There's a SBA. Alright, coming up on our altitude, and I'm real curious to see if it holds it. So we're speeding up to Mach 0.74. Altitude is flight level 280. So far we're holding. Let's see if we get straightened out here. I'm not sure what these are for unless they're showing. I did not set that, but probably set on our radio. Nope, we're still there. Not sure. I know that this would be guide slope and localizer, but I'm not sure why it's here. So it's still struggling to get lined up here. It's indicating a turn, and you can see that our wings are not level. And it should be straight. This is accurate now. So, I'm not sure what I did differently, but it's now holding its altitude. Here's my joystick. Is it looks copacetic. Interesting. Maybe that was it. Looks like it's gonna level itself out here. Red lines are weird, aren't they? Alright, so it's maintaining flight level 28000, and flight level 280. So ground speed of 437. Here's my set speed. Well, after that wild ride, whoops, no smoking. Sorry guys, but let people go to the bathroom. Alright, so the next big milestone is the top of descent, and we can check that here with our progress. So it's showing time 0:01:40. Then mileage is 160 miles. So we've got about 15 minutes of cruise time. One quick look out the window. I think that is San Luis Obispo below us, or what they call slow. Coming up on Paso Robles, wine country. But join me again in a few minutes when we get closer to our top of descent and try the most troubling part for me so far is getting this thing to descend. But I've been reading up and I think I might have a solution, so stand by. Our transition point is Surfer, and we are just a few miles out, just under 5 miles, and then you can see our top of descent. Now, according to the quick guide, which always makes me nervous, I'd really like a full-fledged AOM or FCOM. But one of the things they tell us to do is to dial in our altitude, first altitude below our cruise that we would be cleared to. So I'm just going to go off of our, let's see, where's our phone? So this is 2000, or on flight level 200, sorry. So I'm going to go ahead and dial that in and see when it gets there if it actually does it. It's supposed to automatically begin the descent at top of descent, and you can see on our profile that it's coming up, and this is set to flight level 200. So you would think that it would follow that. So I haven't been able to get it to work yet. Over Big Sur, not very populated. In the Salinas Valley off to the right, as I pointed out before, this is the salad bowl of the U.S. where most of our lettuce is grown. Nice drive. Again, coming up on our top of descent. If you look at our progress, here it is. 9 miles to go. And while we're here, let's just check our approach in our frequency for our ILS is indeed 11.7. You can see that, let's see, here's our star, the min low, and then approach plate here shows 11.7. Alright. Supposed to be there at 1:40, so we are there at 1:40, but this keeps moving. So, folks, it is not automatic. Let's see if it moves again. Alright, something just happened. Path is flashing, we're descending. Good job. SRG. You can see our descent here. Now, will we get to 20,000 feet at this point? I don't know. It says message here. So if I check my messages, I'm not sure where I'm supposed to pick those up. See if there's a message here. Nav data? Not sure, but somehow it's giving me a message. Might be asking for, well, it's not there anymore. The red line is bothersome, isn't it? Go back to our flight plan, and the next one is 1900. I'm just going to go ahead and dial in 15. Yeah. By the way, if you have a trackpad, this is really easy. Just pull your fingers down and sets itself. Alright, so we're to be at 15,000 at Epic. Let's just check Epic 15,000. I never did push my standard barrel. So I guess one of the things you have to do is you have to dial in the altitudes, which I think is not really allowing the FMS to do what it should do. Even in the default FMS it comes with X-plane, it does follow set altitudes. And I read somewhere that if this was in magenta it would be managed, but I've never been able to get it to say that. So we'll just continue our descent for a while, and then you can join me when we get a little bit closer to San Francisco. Scanning the manual, it says here to set your before you begin your descent at cruise altitude, you're supposed to click VNAV after selecting altitude. But apparently I didn't have to. Then it says to select altitudes by clicking on them with the keys on your MCDU. So right now we're coming up on Epic. We're supposed to be at 15,000. We're very close. So we should hit that. But then it says to click this button and it will set it on the MCDU. I'm sorry, the FMA. So I'm going to try that as we cross. See if we can see all of this at once. So we hit Epic. See if it tries to level off or if it continues. So I'm going to go ahead and click this. Now it says format error. So that didn't work. Down to 6,000. And maybe VNAV. So I'm not sure exactly what that means. It says, then confirm the FMS with the altitudes and the star for each waypoint by pressing the corresponding LSK on the right and set them. No, it doesn't do it automatically. You do have to set it by hand. So, my bad. I should have been ready. So at Eddy, we're supposed to be at 6,000. And at Minlo, we are to be at 4,000. And then Seppen is where we intercept the localizer. 3,000. So it's kind of annoying that you have to set these by hand. I would expect an FMS of this quality to do that for you. But hey, gives me something to do, right? Okay, we're leveling off because we are at 10,000. So we continue to descend. Yeah, I don't know how we're going to get there at this rate. Why are we climbing? Let's head south, guys. This is so irritating. We're just flying right over it. Perfect. Alright, I'm going to put that in the bug category, and I doubt we're going to be able to recover. We have a long ways to go. I'm going to go ahead and set this to 4,000. So, does somebody want to explain that to me? So, we're coming down like crazy. Maybe we don't need to be as aggressive. Out the window here, Silicon Valley, folks. Here's San Jose to SJC. And here's Moffett Field. Google keeps their planes there. I thought Memo was over here somewhere, and Seppen was in here. All right, we're getting a message. I don't think it likes the approach speed, but I thought this was... If I can get this switched. Switch, switch, switch. Okay, well, that didn't work. We'll do it by hand. Try to slow down a little bit. Coming up on 4,000. And we want to drop to 3. Man, I wish I could turn this to manual. And I can't slow it down. Maybe that's why it says you need to plug these in beforehand. But you'd think you'd be able to switch it to manual. So if I turn off the FMS and just go to... Nope, it's not going to let me do that either. How about approach? So SEPIN is where we pick up our localizer. This all looks good. I just wish I could get the speed down. Well, it looks like it's being managed for me now. Well, it's allowing me to adjust it now. Another notch of flaps. Didn't like that, it's probably a little soon. Get that ready to go. And gear down. See our runway out here. Alright, looks like we've got the guide slope and the localizer. We want to come across the fence at about 135. Not sure if it gives me those speeds here. So, full flaps. Yeah, it's a good looking airplane, but I'm gonna have to do more study of the whole descent. I don't know what happens at 10,000 feet, but we're doing great until it leveled off at 10,000. Then I had to use vertical speed to change that. So, looking at our FMA, it shows that we are going to flare. Go ahead and set our auto brake to medium. And our happy lights are showing we're right on.
5, huh?
Message is still there. Maybe I should have cleared that. So I need a better understanding of how the FMS controls speeds. But I guess that's why you're supposed to enter them before you begin your descent. Right?
50, 40, 30. 20.
And the nose comes 10. Up. No, I didn't touch a thing. And reverse. Down to 70.
Auto brake.
That's... So that was very nicely automated. So I like a lot of things about this airplane, but the use of the FMS for those altitudes are less than exciting. Or is less than exciting, sorry. Need to concentrate here. Okay, they cleared us to cross this runway. And as we pull in, my buddy Steve would want to look for an auto gate. But I'm just going to try to get this thing parked. Now, if I wasn't actually flying this airplane, I would reach up and flip on the APU. Whoops. There we go. So let's turn on our APU. Of course, we could get the ground power going now that we're here. Is it available? Yep. Now, engine's off. All right, that's our flight. Oops, I should have turned off the strobe and rolled up those flaps after we landed. But I don't have a really good checklist for this, so I need to come up with my own and then actually pay attention to it. So thanks for joining me. Sorry this was a little bit disjointed, but again, I'm still trying to get used to this aircraft and you're kind of exploring it with me. Thank you.